So if you haven't watched the most recent episodes of Attack on Titan, I suggest you do not watch this video. It's been a while. It feels so weird like doing this right now. It's like, Anna, it's been so long since I last talked into a camera and had to tell my whole family I'm recording, don't come in. This is so weird. Originally, I just thought Titans was a good series. I mean, the whole thing where Titans are outside the walls and everything, you know, it's really deep. We have to have walls. And then these Titans, when they break through the walls, they drive humanity further in. And it's whole despair, like, kind of atmosphere. Attack on Titan is not like all those animes, like, no offense to Fairy Tail, but it's not like Fairy Tail where, like, they'll be against, like, some like really bad opponents, and then they'll be like, we can fight with the power of friendship, and they'll go and win. It's not like that at all, because I feel like Attack on Titan has this very serious, realistic vibe. So like, if there's someone who you can't fight, you can't fight. And it's just they do not like make it like so that the strength of will decides where the war's gonna be, because everyone already has a strong will to survive. So yeah, that's one thing I like about Attack on Titan. It's realistic. The recent episodes have actually blown me away. I actually thought, I knew there'd be a twist, okay? I knew there'd be something outside the walls I'm all scared of, blah, blah, blah. I knew that, okay, we eat human beings, we're going to do this. Okay, that's pretty messed up. Okay, yeah. But then the twist, two different countries are fighting and one country gets turned into titans and shit. I was like, what the fuck? What the fuck? Like, this is way more insane than I ever thought it would be. I mean, we all knew that there are humans outside the walls. There must have been for us to have all these special human beings who have missions. Like, you know how Reyna's always talking about how he has a mission, he's a soldier, he's this, he's that. So I mean, I always knew that, but then it's just like, I didn't see the depth of it, and it's just amazing. Attack on Titan author, what's your name?
Attack on Titan name, author.
Hajime Isayama. You're a genius, man. You're a genius. It's like we're looking at two different centuries. Like, there are people who are living inside the walls, like War Maria and all that stuff, like Eren's people. Those guys are like living in like the 1970s. Well, the people inside the other people, the Malians or whatever their names are, they're living in like the 1990s. And it's just insane. It's just so much depth. Like, I mean, I don't know how to explain. I'm just like, I did not see it coming. I did not see that it'd be so deep. Like, I just thought there'd be like a little territory outside that's like burning up titans because they're freaking insane, and like they just think, oh, it's cool to torture the rest of humanity. That's what I thought. But this is like so much deeper than that, you know? You know there's always that friction between like an old wife and a new wife. I think he thought, how can I put that into my story? Ooh, I'll have the old wife eat the new wife, and that'd be so awesome. Yeah, let's do it. I mean, what? Recently, I've been watching a few episodes of Walking Dead with my brother and sister. Like, right now, I'm watching season 9. So, spoiler alert for season 9. If you're not there yet, then skip this part. Recently, I've been watching The Walking Dead, and like, I've been seeing like stuff like how they live inside walls so the walkers can't come inside and stuff like that. And I'm just like, these walls they live in, yeah? It's like these are exactly the same kind of walls they live in Attack on Titan. And it just got me thinking, I was like, imagine if like the author like was a fan of like The Walking Dead, like if he was, then it's like he just thought, how can I put, ooh! I saw like he just picked different ideas in different places. Like he got the drama from all those soap operas where you have the old wife and the new wife fighting. He was like, okay, I'm gonna make the old wife eat the new wife. Okay, and he went to Walking Dead, he was like, okay, they live in walls to stay away from walkers. Okay, I'm gonna make them live in walls to stay away from titans. And he just got pieced together a story like that. And it made it into an awesome piece of masterpiece, and I'm grateful that you made the story, but I'm gonna have nightmares for the rest of my life now. Thank you. Boom. So as of now, I'm still kind of crap, but I feel like my best drawings is this one. So even though Udemy has not sponsored this video, but they should, because this is all thanks to them, and I'm gonna keep gloating about how awesome their courses are and stuff. So right now I've been doing the drawing course, and compared to my original drawings, like the ones, if you look, check out my animations, you can tell my original drawings are kind of crap, but like I'm pretty sure that's a good example of one of my original drawings. Yeah, but then the Udemy course maybe get better. So although I'm not as perfect as I want to be, which is why I won't be doing animations for a while, this is what I'm capable of as of now. And you'll be seeing better in the future. So yeah. Thanks guys for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. Papa Randall will be coming back next week.